So you have to choose between one of these two scenarios. Mm-hmm. Amazing relationship. Horrible sex.
Oh, shit.
Amazing, incredible sex. Horrible, toxic relationship.
Life too short, go spoil yourself. Feel that, feel, enjoy yourself. Cause we have everything we need.
Blood exchange.
Blood exchange. Ladies, I don't know what's happening.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls across the world, Blood Exchange is back.
Blood Exchange
yo.
Is
back.
Welcome back to the Blood Exchange, episode
12. Doce.
And today is a different day. It's a different kind of thing going on.
Damn, I wanted to.
It's a different air in the room.
I completely forgot why we're here.
Yeah.
This is not why we're here, but.
You know, the Blunt Exchange doesn't stop for anything, so, you know, we weren't going to stop the episode.
Yeah.
We're going to keep going, but we wanted to show, pay our respects to a legend and a hero and somebody that a lot of people looked up to, did a lot of great things for a lot of people, and just a great man in general. Kobe Bryant. Rest in peace, Kobe Bryant.
Kobe Bean Bryant.
If you don't know, it means you don't live in the world. Kobe Bryant.
If you're hearing it from us, we appreciate that.
Yes. But if this is the first time you're hearing this, I question what's happening in your life right now, to be honest with you. Something's not right. But if you don't know, Kobe Bryant was killed early Sunday morning.
Yeah.
In a helicopter crash in Los Angeles.
Calabasas? The Calabasas area of Los Angeles.
So he died with his young daughter, 13-year-old daughter, Gigi, and about, what, seven other people, friends, and a pilot.
His daughter's teammate and two of their parents.
Yeah.
And those two parents that died are leaving behind another two children as well.
Yeah.
But there's no parents.
It's so definitely a tragedy. It's definitely one of the craziest stories I've ever heard. I was saying to Crump the other day that this is the first time an athlete died that really, it got me.
I agree.
I felt it. You know, like Muhammad Ali died the other day. That's epic, but he was just a little bit out of touch. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We didn't see him really. So
yeah.
For me,
go ahead. No,
I'm sorry.
It was more like highlights, and we're watching, you know, replays and highlights and documentaries and stuff. But we didn't experience it.
You didn't go through the experience.
Yeah. So we didn't see what his impact was like on society.
Yeah.
But we see what his impact, the impact that he left behind. So we have the respect for Muhammad Ali also. But Kobe was the first one that touched me.
Yeah, for me personally, he was the first celebrity that I feel our generation really grew up with to see coming out of high school, 17, 18-year-old kid coming out of high school, killing it in basketball, going to prom with Brandy, being on one of the first rappers, one of the first basketball players that wanted to start rapping.
Yeah.
Came to the Rucker. It's crazy. Like, you really feel like, I feel like it was one of my older cousins because it just felt like you were growing up with Kobe. You grew up with Kobe. And
he jumped over a car.
Jumped over a pool of snakes.
Pool of mamba snakes.
Yeah.
So it's just real crazy I still honestly don't even believe it.
Yeah, it seems so surreal. I was saying that the other day. It seems like it's not true.
It's true.
Because we just saw Kobe on Saturday.
Yeah.
We heard from him. He was talking on Saturday because, you know, the whole scoring, lead or whatever, scoring record. But it's just crazy that out of nowhere, you know, you're here today, you're gone tomorrow. Mm-hmm. You have a favorite Kobe story, Kobe anything?
I think the closest one. I didn't root a lot for Kobe.
Okay. I'm not going to lie. I wasn't the biggest Lakers supporter at the time, you know?
Yeah, LeBron overshadowed him a bit, and, you know, he was over there on the West. But he had that run when they didn't make the playoffs for like 7 or 8 years, I think.
At the end, the five or six years.
And then in 2008, in 2010, when he went and got 2009, 2010, when they put together that team with Powell, which I liked. I was a big Powell fan.
Uh-huh.
So then that made me watch Lakers games at that time. So then that brought me, to watch.
And they had that back-to-back year battle with the Celtics. That was a great.
Exactly.
The Celtics got him one time, and they came and got him back.
And I saw a lot more of him than what I had watched in a few.
You have any more Kobe stories or anything that you stands
just so out many just different dunks and yeah, like
the dunk contest definitely.
Like, can we show a couple of the dunks? Because we were just looking at a highlight. We can show a couple. We can show a couple of them, right?
It's just so many like 360 windmill alley oop catch dunks and stuff like that. You just see like his attention to detail and stuff like that. Could you hear the stories about how he was 18 and not really able to hang out with his teammates because they're all over 21 and they're going out drinking and stuff like that. So he had to just be in the gym working on his game. And you see that drive. You don't really see that a lot or that competitive nature. That yeah, his competitive nature.
He was a dog. So. Like everybody that talks about Kobe said his
competitive. Yeah. In the 81 point, he has he's second all time in single game performances. 81 points, like that might be my favorite Kobe moment.
My favorite Kobe moment, besides the cool moments after they win the championships.
Dropping 50 on Jordan,
that was crazy. Going crazy on Jordan in the All Star game in New York, that was crazy.
Yeah.
61 points in the Garden because Spike Lee was talking shit. Spike Lee, you always do this to us, Spike.
Yeah,
always. Mm-hmm. Kobe dropped 61, and that for a while was the highest amount scored in the Garden.
Until that man came through.
Mello.
Woo!
62 in the Garden.
Doma, half court.
Knicks record, baby.
You heard me? Hold that. But, Kobe, we love you. We're going to miss you, man. You left some big shoes.
It's crazy,
they never really fill your shoes, but, we'll try. We'll try to... live the Mamba, Mamba mentality?
The Mamba mentality.
Strive for greatness. So I see a lot on social media. They're saying, they're trying to change the game 21 to 24.
I support that.
And if you miss the shot to go to 24, you go to 8.
I mean, it's worth a couple more points either way. That's how we played 21 anyway. We used to play 21. I'm down with that. I support that. Blunt Exchange supports changing from 21 to 24.
I mean, I don't know if I want to change 21 to 24.
They
want to
change the logo, too.
Yeah, I also saw that Mark Cuban is retiring the number 24 for the Mavericks.
He's
the owner of a team. That's what he can do.
And I honestly heard from Spencer Dinwiddie said that there's a lot of players in the league that are taking between the players, they're choosing to not wear 24 or 8 anymore because to show some player love for Kobe.
And that's what's up. Everyone showed they do their own tribute. And on Blunt Exchange, we're going to tribute the way we know best. We'll light one. And then we'll do...
let's do the moment of silence first, and then...
And then light one?
Yeah, we'll do a three-blunt salute, like a three-puff salute or something like that.
All right, well, we're going to give them, 24 seconds?
24 seconds. For Kobe. Everybody.
24 seconds.
Starting.
For Kobe.
Yo, R.I.P. Kobe. Yo, real talk. Kobe B. Bryant.
And I rooted against you for mad shit.
Yo, always respect.
Always respect.
Always
respect. You're the man, Kobe.
Yo, man. Yeah, we're done on Kobe, but as a competitor, as a competitor, yo, Kobe was up there as one of the top five most competitive athletes I've seen, yo. And he wouldn't want nobody else to take a soft on him or nothing like that. So. Shout out to Kobe. He left it all on the court. Real talk.
Facts. But nothing beats that moment when he told reporters, "I got one over Shaq." Nothing beats that moment.
Shaq got out of his face and said, "Kobe, how my ass tastes." So you know it's gonna get crazy after that.
It don't matter though. He sat Shaq there. And he said, "Yo, that was the first thing he said to them when they started the interview. That's the first thing he said. I got one over Shaq. All right, hold that. Then you go tell him that.
Huh?
Go tell him that."
So let me ask you a question, let me ask you a question, Bleak.
That was real.
Let me ask you a question, Bleak.
Yes.
If you don't mind.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of butt is this? Butt of the day.
Butt of the day.
I think that sound is the grinder, right?
Yeah.
That's what that is?
Yeah.
Because first I thought it was a train. I'm like, what's going on?
No, yeah. Maybe it's the, it is the grinder.
It's the grinder.
It's the grinder.
Butt of the day. What do we got today?
Butt of the day. Kobe.
The Black Mamba OG is back.
Brought it back.
Mamba OG.
Just for Kobe.
It's only right for us to bring back
a 5-time champion. Man. 18-time All-Star. One-time MVP.
Top 10 player.
Six rings.
All-time player.
Bad Bunny told us six rings.
Arguable.
I mean.
You know.
It's six rings. That's, you know,
that's not. But you know. Anyway.
Couldn't even let Kobe's it rock.
Hey.
You
hey,
were talking
it's the
about
blood
hate.
Exchange. We keep it blunt.
Oh.
Here we go.
Let's get into it, guys.
Let's get it.
Should I ask y'all about your weekends?
Here we are.
Should I ask you about your weekends?
It was whack. Kobe died.
Yeah,
Kobe died,
bro.
It was trash.
Yeah, man. It shut down after that. It was over, bro.
It was over after Kobe died.
Yeah, man. Shit was crazy.
We have some guests in the studio. Bleak, shout about.
Shout out to Dip. He's in the studio with us today.
We shout out Dip. We shout out Dip so many times on the show. Like, I feel like y'all should see his face, but not yet.
Shout out to the Google God. Come.
You heard? We finally got the Google God. He pulled up.
Google God woke up.
Yeah, and he's on fucking thin fucking ice. Yeah, I'll let you know that right now. One mistake and he's out of here.
Yeah, he sent a bunch of emails.
One typo.
Right back over the wall.
Yeah, we didn't read any of those emails he sent either. So.
Okay, you guys ready for the word of the day?
Word
of the day. And this is an easy one. If you guys don't know this, I'm trying to give y'all words that will pop up in your life that you need to know.
Exactly.
That you just might hear all the time, but you don't really know what they mean.
Okay. Prepare.
Chicanery.
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 Yeah, I have no idea.
Damn, sounds like Shakira.
Chicanery.
Oh, like foolish. No, I'm not going to guess.
Foolish? You going with foolish?
I'm not
it's not
guess.
Bad. You might have something there. You might have something there.
Good shit, Crook. Good shit, Crook.
Dirty niggas?
I didn't even see it.
Okay, niggas can't read anyway.
So you dig?
Just text it to me next time, Crook.
No, so any guesses, guys?
Why can't I read one of black?
Can we hear it in
the word black? Any guesses for
I chose to read.
Can we get it in a sentence?
Yeah, can I get a sentence? No, you don't want to give it up in the sentence.
Yes, he does.
Nah, the sentence gives it up. Oh, but I can get it. I can make you a sentence anyway. Well, any sentence gives this one up, man. You guys should know this word, man. Guess give me a guess.
I don't know what it means.
Any sentence will give it up. Any sentence will give it up.
So that you should have picked a better word.
That's not my fault.
Yeah, man. Just tell us.
I need a sentence. I've never heard that word before. I need the sentence.
James Harden, although he scores lots of points like Kobe, uses way more chicanery to get his baskets.
Moves? Style? Dribble?
Elusivity?
I mean, from the sentence, you can. That's a word that you would come from, but that's not the answer.
Uh-huh. Say the sentence again?
I just made it up.
All right.
James Harden, although he scores mad buckets like Kobe Bryant, uses a lot more chicanery to get his points.
That was great.
He uses more fouls, more refs,
uses
more
calls.
Energy? Struggles more.
Does he use more energy? I don't know. Does he use more?
Come on, stop making us look like fools here.
Yeah, man.
Just say it.
I went to college. I graduated.
Sheesh.
I don't know the word.
That's that. Yeah, man.
I'm honest.
The use of trickery to achieve a political, financial, or legal purpose.
Oh, well, I was...
Oh, yeah, you're talking about Tate.
It's just trickery.
Oh, okay, okay.
Chicanery is like using...
Okay, I got it. Yeah, I got you. Yeah, the way he be drawing the fouls.
Deception, trickery, deceit. Those are synonyms. Similar words.
Right.
So, chicanery.
Chicanery.
So, when you hear that again, you know...
I thought that was something to do with bananas.
Yeah.
Chiquita bananas.
I thought Shakira, and then I thought her, and then I didn't think anymore.
Chicanery.
Yeah, like.
All right, guys. So another word we learned today. You want to jump straight into?
You know what it is.
Power talk.
Power talk.
Yeah, vote for Tate.
Vote for Tate.
Oh, who's calling? Bye.
Oh, shout out Joe Easy. Damn, he's about to find out. He's about to find out about Kobe if he hasn't already.
Yeah,
okay.
Definitely knows. That changed the world right there.
Yeah, man. Everybody was on hold.
So Power Talk, guys. Talk to me. Everyone saw the episode?
Yeah.
Of course.
It was show homework.
Yes.
And what do we think?
Yo, man, it's got to be Tariq.
Wow.
Tariq is definitely the killer. It's Tariq or Tasha.
Are you talking about the leaks you've been seeing on the internet?
I have not watched one leak.
It sounds like
I don't watch one leak, but like I don't want to, like, spoiler alert.
Well, you know, once we talk about Power Talk, you do a spoiler alert. Because we get
I just feel we've seen everybody's lead up story except for.
Facts.
We've seen him in 2 episodes. He's not the killer, yo. If you think he's the killer, you're dumb. That would be the waste of the century. Why would Ghost tell Tommy to not get fucking sacks if that was him? In my opinion, he's saying, yo, leave him alone, as in that's Tasha or
youngest child's name.
The youngest one?
The one that doesn't really exist half the time.
The forever 2-year-old?
Yeah. The one that disappears for like 5-6 episodes and comes back.
Ask the Google guy.
What's James St. Patrick's 3 children's names?
Yeah.
Tariq, the one, the potato head girl that died, and then what's the other
Raina.
One?
Raina.
Yeah, potato head Raina, and then what was the last one? Okay, Google guy's working on that, but she might have done it. We'd have never expected it.
That's not her.
Okay. What about Tasha's mom?
Hold on. No. Let's get into the episode.
Okay.
Do you believe Cedric the Entertainer is a gangster?
Wow. I can believe it if I take myself out of the Gary mind. Cedric the Entertainer's old fat ass. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Old funny ass fat nigga.
Yeah.
Like, if I take my mind out of that, mm-hmm. Yeah. He's a regular black. He could be a gangster.
Yeah. Okay.
I
mean, I believed it.
Yo.
You heard that, right?
I believed it.
Hey, just a black man. Of course, yeah. He definitely looks like he committed a crime.
James
St. Patrick's daughter is named Yaz. Yaz killed him.
Yaz.
Thank you, Google guy.
Oh! Google guy.
Yasmin St. Patrick, thank you, with the official name. I see you.
Yeah, so let me ask you another question. As one black man to another black man, I mean, I'm sorry. Let me ask you another question. From one black man to another black man, yeah. All right, yeah. Is Tate Grime for shitting on Ramona, for shitting on Jamie's ex-lover? Google guy, find out who the light-skinned joint is. The one that...
What's the light-skinned joint? From who?
Ramona's? Oh, that is
Ramona
her name.
Ramona is James St. Patrick's campaign manager.
Yeah, Tate was like...
At the end, he just threw the dirt on her. You got to get all your enemies, you got to feel your vengeance.
Even if she's black, you got shitting on the black woman.
It's not about being white or black. It's my enemy. I'm not my enemy. I can't trust you, so I kill you when I get the chance because you'll kill me.
I feel that.
It's a dirty game.
Okay.
You see, Tate had to hit it one more time.
How do you feel about her? You think she's attractive?
What?
I'm asking you that specifically because I know that's a touchy question. She's not ugly.
She's not ugly.
You think she's attractive?
The
Tate's
little the fake Lynn Whitfield. The fake Lynn Whitfield joint.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If we have time, I want to get to a topic that we addressed in the first episode and we never came back to, and I want to really do it.
What is that?
If we have the time at the end.
Okay.
Build the perfect joint.
Okay. So
one more of the episode.
So what else? Boom. So the episode ended with us about to find out who they thought was the first suspect or the lead suspect in the murder of James St. Patrick, which I still don't believe like Kobe.
You don't believe he's dead?
I don't believe he's dead. I know he's dead, but I don't believe it.
Okay.
They say he's dead, but I don't know. I can't put my finger on it, bro.
Go ahead.
No, say what you said.
No. I mean... Few episodes, you know, I've been saying it's Ramona that shot him, right?
Yeah, uh-huh. You said that in the beginning. You thought it was Ramona.
And this episode kind of proved it even more for me.
Oh, really?
Definitely
how?
Down
like,
Ramona.
This proved my theory. Like, it kind of like gave me some.
Give you some legs?
Yeah.
Or wings, legs. Like past legs.
Oh,
wings.
A lot.
Oh.
A lot of things you guys missed because I hear you talking, but I don't hear you talking about the things that I saw.
I think you were probably smoking before you got here.
I
feel like that episode took Ramona out of it.
She came in at perfect timing if you listen to what she's saying.
Okay.
And there was a couple scenes.
Talk to me.
Well, okay.
Does she even know how to shoot a gun?
Talking about the end, and at the end was the perfect, she gave it away. But moments before that, when Tate threw her under the bus.
Okay.
When Tate was talking to the reporters, he looked to his left and he saw that.
She was out there talking to reporters.
So was it reporters or was it agents?
Reporters.
How do you know?
It was reporters.
I thought they were reporters.
We'll look it over.
Could have been agents. All I saw was a pad.
Okay. Oh, but like the reporters have pads.
Agents have pads. So
they do too.
And she was looking to her right.
Paz has a
guy.
Who Paz has a pad.
Talking to at the end of the episode. Just look at the picture. Was it agents or was it like fucking
reporters? Anyway, she looked to the right and she looked in a frantic state. She had her hands in her pocket and she was looking to her right in kind of like a pacey, frantic state. Right? Then he decided to shit on her. Then he looked again. She was gone. Mm-hmm. Fast forward, when they're in the house, they meet again. She's knocking at the door. Urgency, urgency. Open the door. She comes in. Why did you tell the reporter
that I fucked James St. Patrick?
James St. Patrick.
She's trying to fuck his, he's trying to fuck her career up.
Yes, yeah. But
she's like, I didn't.
That gives motive.
Why?
To agents.
Yeah.
That having gives motive. A personal relationship. She's like, yo, why did you do that? Minutes later, she you walks out. We don't know how much time passed when she left the door and when that news came on. Because then they said they got the first suspect. She could have been arrested downstairs. We don't know. As she walked out the door.
Yo, that makes total sense.
This is power, see, my
see,
people.
That makes total sense.
This is
sense,
power,
Blake.
My people.
See, I just.
Wow.
You're welcome.
My guy.
See, fine. I feel you. I hear you. I just don't agree.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. It's just a theory. It's not.
Because for me, I feel that he was just trying to tarnish her whole her name, right?
Those intentions.
So because the reason why we know her in the first place is because she was cheated on. So the reason why she broke up with her first husband is because he cheated on her, and she was now working with Tate to try and refix her name to establish herself separate from him.
Yes.
So I feel that him saying that about her just really put a nail in her coffin for not being somebody you can honestly trust and rely, because this is too sexual. He tried to, if she didn't sleep with him, she's trying to create he's trying to create a second sexual
scandal
for her so where she can't work in the business no more. Now it's just, if you work with her, she's going to sleep with your man.
But
so that's, in my opinion, that's why I feel it has more to do with that. Jamie.
But this is the best part about what you said. That is the plain obvious.
It is, though.
It's too obvious. It's too easy. This is power.
But look at the writing of power. The power's not that. The power's not that.
Who writes power?
Wait.
Yeah. Tommy's dialogue?
But let me give you something on Tate. I also think that since the episode was about Tate, then we're talking about luck. And if you go back a little further, the entire episode
was about Tate's
luck. Tate is trying to do good.
Who's trying to do
this? Is he?
Yes, because he went
to... No, he's not.
He was a dirty ass.
All right, let him finish.
He went to Ghost to tell him, bro, there's some people behind you. I fucked up. Yeah. He's walking in telling them, I fucked up.
Yeah.
And, you know,
but Ghost was on his ego. In his bag.
I'm in my bag. I got the shit.
Nobody's stopping me from having it.
Then he continues. Then he goes, he gets his information from Dre. He takes that information back to Tasha. He tells her, yo, you're not going to even give up this guy, Ghost, for your son? He's still trying to do good.
No, he's trying to get Tasha to kill him.
No, he's trying to
In my opinion,
get him locked.
I feel she's trying to say he's trying to get Tasha to kill Ghost by saying, like, yo, they're about to put your son away. He's about to snitch on your son.
Yeah, exactly. So lock him up. You gotta go to the cops.
Kill him.
He never said kill him, he said go to the cops. And also, everything he's doing, he goes to his brother, right? He's at the house. He's at his brother. He tells his brother what he's doing. Then he goes outside. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, even though Tate was involved, he's actually trying to do good the entire time.
That's a good argument.
It's a good theory.
It's a good theory. It's a good theory.
You know what I mean?
It makes sense.
I'm just saying.
It makes sense.
Just a good theory. Hold on.
I don't know. It makes sense. But
no, we got one more.
For Ramona. Do we have one more episode?
Wait,
is that confirmed that we have one more episode?
I'm not done.
I don't think it was one more episode.
I'm not done. The episode is so good. I forgot.
Okay.
So, Ramona, why? Okay. So then, right, you're thinking, why did he tell then Tommy to not shoot her? Don't shoot her. Because she didn't really kill me. Remember, also, they showed Ghost in front of the mirror, kind of like when he was unbuttoning his shirt, they showed him go like this and look at it and go like that and then close it. And then the scene went off. That could have been him master planning it of like, I'm going to get shot here.
When did he do that?
I got the shit. Huh?
He got the squib underneath the shirt?
Yep.
Wow.
Don't shoot her. She didn't really kill me, Tommy.
I still, honestly, like Will, have the little doubt in the back of my mind that Ghost is still alive and this is some master plan with Tommy.
Yeah, I think so.
I do have that, like that little 5% chance, but 95%.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Tommy, she didn't really kill me. She didn't really kill me. Don't shoot her. She's going to jail. Don't worry about it. This is good stuff, guys.
So, yeah?
I'm telling you, yeah.
No?
Yeah. How you like that?
Anything else for power? You good?
I it If Ghost is still alive, this is a great way to like die, like a big public death.
Yeah.
So nobody's looking for
him. No one's looking for you no more, and it's over.
So yeah, that's power.
Wow, power, man. Wow, you guys are finishing up strong.
Yeah, that's my theory.
This might be finishing up so strong that we'll definitely tune into this next shit that you got going.
Ghost book.
The book of ghosts.
The book of ghosts of Tommy.
Power book. Ghost. Ghost, the power book story.
How many volumes?
Sponsored by Popeye's Chicken.
Okay,
for Mary J. Blige.
Okay. Tommy got a show, allegedly.
Tommy got a show. No, it's not allegedly. 50 Cent posted it. They had the Tommy hat and all that.
Yeah, man. It's the internet. I don't believe anything.
I mean, you could check. Google guy could check it.
Google guy. Is Tommy really getting a show? We'll get back to you on that one.
Yeah.
Anything else with power before we get the fuck out of here?
I think we're done.
We're all done?
Yes, sir.
So the final guess is on who killed Ghost. Is Ghost dead? Is Ghost dead?
No.
Who killed Ghost?
No one killed
Ghost. Who fake killed Ghost?
Ramona.
Is Ghost dead?
If he is dead, it's because of Tariq, and if he's not dead, it's because I said so.
Oh, okay. But if he is really dead, Ramona then killed him for real. But she killed him.
95% of...
95%, I really think he's dead. I really think he's dead.
95%, I think he's dead, and if he really died, I do think Tariq did it. And if he's not dead, this is an elaborate plan with Tommy, and they're like in L.A. getting wild chicken right now. So... Yeah, so... So there is a spinoff for Tommy. Tommy's definitely getting a show. Mary J. Blige is on it. So
Method
I can't
Man's
wait
on
for
it.
The 411 on that. Can't wait for the 411. All right, guys? And we're moving on from power.
Yeah.
Anything else, guys, before I get to the rundown?
Nah. That's it. Run it down. Run it down. Run down.
All right, let's run down on these bitches.
Let's get it.
Antonio Brown.
Yo, man, he's a wild man.
So Antonio Brown is in the news again. He's there was a warrant for his arrest. They picked him up.
He threw a rock at a truck or something like that?
He's done a lot of things. This is a long list of things. If you want Google guy, as soon as we start talking about this shit, you should just like start looking through the shit for the future references. So Antonio Brown just got picked up. There was a warrant for his arrest. He has a long list of prior incidents and events. So yeah, it's definitely stupidness. And now they say he's facing life in prison.
Crazy.
Throw that rock.
He's out on bail because he had a burglary charge and an assault charge. And the way things work.
Hopefully he's innocent.
There's a chance he could get life in prison.
Because why would he be robbing people or attempting anything?
No, I think it's like what he did is technically assault or technically murder.
Yeah.
So like, when you have both of those, those are both felonies, right?
I just feel he'll get out of it eventually because he's rich. And he has money.
Yeah, but he's a dumbass, though.
Oh, are we talking about that's in question? Oh, I mean, he's a dumbass.
If you're a dumbass, like, you know, yeah, dumbasses dumbass. Will find the way to fuck it up.
Yeah, every
you
time.
You know what I mean? Like, he shouldn't be.
Every time. He should be
no
playing.
Way that he should be facing life in prison right now for the shit that he did. But because he's a dumbass, they're definitely going to throw the book at him.
Damn. It's unfortunate. It's unnecessary.
Yeah, and the thing is, Antonio Brown, you were definitely going to be a Hall of Famer first ballot. You might still be a Hall of Famer if niggas aren't grime. Because you have Hall of Fame stats. But when you carry yourself like a stupid motherfucker,
like a poopot,
like a dumb motherfucker, then dumb motherfucking shit happens to you.
It's just very unfortunate, you know?
Yeah.
It's very unfortunate. That's
anything about Antonio Brown before we move on?
Nah, man, it's just an unfortunate situation for him.
Yeah,
battery
and burglary. And he's facing life in prison, right? That's a possibility. So Antonio Brown, we don't want you to go to jail for life because I think that would be a gross overreaction. But sometimes when you act dumb as shit, we gotta find a way to get through to you. And I guess the way to get through to you is scare you with the possibility of life in prison.
Charge you bad money.
Yeah.
Nah, man.
I don't know. Nobody deserves life in prison unless you
you know, there's some kind of evil shit.
Okay, so from Antonio Brown, you wanna stay in sports?
Yeah.
LeBron James is now.
Oh, about no. Hold on. Stop. End over Super Bowl. Might as well stick.
We'll go to Super Bowl right after Antonio Brown.
Same sport.
So since we're talking about Antonio Brown sports, you want to go to Super Bowl?
Yeah, we gotta give our picks.
Super Bowl prediction. All
right, bet. What y'all want to bet? Y'all each bet on a team.
We all bet on.
No, y'all each bet on a team, and I bet on somebody winning. Like, I bet that somebody wins. And it's not a draw.
No.
Why not?
We're all going to bet the same thing.
We each want to have an equal...
No, we all bet the same thing.
Yes. Oh. Yeah.
So we're going to pick team. Right. Pick them, win or loss.
49ers, 49ers, 49ers. Go with the 49ers.
Kansas City Chiefs. Mahomes.
My homeboy?
My homeboy.
Mahomes.
He's definitely about to get
shit
hit up.
I want Mahomes to win.
No, you want San Francisco. You're a San Francisco guy.
No, no, no. I want Mahomes to win.
All over you.
I want Mahomes to get a chip.
I think 49ers are going to win, though.
So what y'all want to bet? What y'all want to bet? What y'all want to bet? Malik, what you want to bet? You outnumbered, so I mean you could go first.
Yeah, what would be the bet? I don't know.
If you win,
yeah,
what will we do?
Whoa.
What do you want to wager for the for this
like,
bet?
You know, we could talk what some beers or something.
Some beers or something like that.
If we win, you got to drink like E&J or something like that. Like you got to take like two shots.
We never did shots.
A couple shots.
Two shots
of
whatever it is.
Of bad liquor, cheap liquor.
Listen, there's got to be a limit. There's got to be a limit. There's only
another you can't go lower than
$5.
$5. Nah, that's too low,
that's
bro. Chill
easy
out.
To be trash.
I know. That's the point.
$10.
No.
Can't go any lower than 10.
No.
Because that's like Henny. At least it's Henny.
No, Henny. No, it has to be bad liquor. It can't be more than
$10. Some people consider Henny
it can't
to be bad liquor.
Yeah. We aren't those people.
We're not, but
we aren't those people.
It's all perspective.
It's all perspective. So,
all right, so a bottle of E&J or a bottle of like Jesus Jesus or something like that.
I haven't drank E&J. I haven't drank E&J since.
So you bet the Chiefs are gonna win?
Okay, okay. Whoever loses has to take three shots of green apple E&J.
I haven't even heard of that shit.
Yuck.
Before.
That is the most disgusting thing I can think of.
Yeah.
Or peach E&J.
Yeah.
Or peach Paul Masson.
Actually, you know what? Why do we don't leave it? Why we don't leave it to
yeah,
to
I'm
the,
down with that. I'm down with
that.
Why
we don't leave it to the public?
Oh, I will throw up.
Give some comments and tell us what they think.
Whoever can get the most likes on their comment for what this bet should be, we will take it into consideration.
Yeah. If it's not as trash, we're going to have that green apple shit.
Then we're going to do one of the E&J trashes, like the pints. We'll buy it, and then we take the shots from there. Yeah? That's disgusting.
Yeah, it's fine.
And it'll actually still get you lit, though.
Yeah.
So
nobody wants to
that might be interesting. Yeah, right at the beginning of the show, too. Like, before we even talk, you already know what it is. Take these three shots.
Bam, bam, bam.
And then go into the show.
Yeah,
hell yeah.
All right.
That's the bet.
That's cool.
49ers, 49ers, Chiefs.
Yeah, Mahomes.
I wish I picked Chiefs. To
no,
be
you
with
did
you.
It.
I really did.
I written it for the job. You wanted the Niners. No homo.
I want the Chiefs to win.
You want the Chiefs to win.
Yeah.
But yo, I'm not going for the Chiefs because they let my man Tamba go.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to Tamba. Tamba, what's up, man? Pull up. Tamba, pull up. What's good?
You retired now.
Yeah,
so.
Man, come talk to us. Tell us what the NFL was like. And my other NFL niggas. I want to mention your names, but pull up. Talk to me. All right. And is there anything else in
NFL? No, that's it. That's it. That's really
so,
it.
Man.
Anything else in NFL?
Jerry Rice will still bust Randy Moss ass.
We talked about that already.
I know, but I'm just wanting to reassure.
Randy Moss
is
better than him.
You just
want to
reassure.
He's a freak.
No, Jerry Rice is still the man.
He was a freak.
He's still the man.
More sports. Basketball. LeBron James, number 3 all-time in scoring. The GOAT makes his way up the ladder.
Yeah, congratulations.
The GOAT makes his way up the ladder to his rightful throne.
He's not the GOAT. Don't try and sleep.
The GOAT.
Abe thinks that LeBron is a GOAT. He's the only one on this show that thinks that LeBron is a GOAT. Bleak, is he the GOAT? He thinks he's a GOAT? Oh.
So let's talk about this. Yo, so we got a list. One of the staff sent it in to us. It's from Barstool.
Shout out to camera guy.
Shout out to the camera guy, master of photography. Master?
Master.
Photography? Director?
Master.
Photography
master
director?
Of photography.
Shout out to the
he needs a sword now.
The photography director. Brian Johnson.
The jack of photography.
Brian Johnson.
Grand Wizard. Yeah.
He just
Johnson.
Made some racist
and,
comments.
And
I don't
Mr.
know.
And Mr.
But shout out to Brian Johnson. He's the director of photography. He brought to our attention this list from Bleacher Report, the top 10 players
Bleacher
of all
Report.
Time.
Okay.
Do you want to hear what their top 10 players of all time is?
Yes.
And then we can discuss it if anyone needs to be left off or anything you want to talk about.
Quick. Okay, this is rapid.
1, Jordan. 2,
the GOAT.
LeBron. 3, Kareem. 4, Magic. 5, Bird. 6, Shaq. 7, Duncan. 8, Bill Russell. 9, Wilt. 10, Steph Curry.
Yeah, I'm cool with anything? That list. I'm cool with that list, except for a couple of people you got to take off.
Who needs to be off of this list?
Yeah, man. I didn't even I'm at the it. Point where we're taking Bill Russell off the top 10 list.
That sounds insane and blasphemous, yeah, but man. Let me hear you out.
Yeah, man.
You sound like an insane person, but let me hear you out. Mm.
Basketball skill-wise?
He has the most championships ever.
It's a team sport, so it doesn't even
he's
matter.
He's the captain of the team and the coach and the player.
I mean, but you don't even you personally don't even use that as a ruling stick to say who's the nicest of all time. So, know what I mean?
I'm just asking you.
I just feel I take Bill Russell off and put Kobe on that list.
Bill Russell off.
I'm taking Bill Russell off that list and putting Kobe and rearranging it a little bit.
I will definitely rearrange this heavily. Bill Russell is off that list for me. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Oh, so
but not on some hater shit. But not on some hater shit.
I'm not hating.
And Curry is off that list automatically. Yes. That's insane.
I'm definitely keeping Bill though.
So I'll creep Kobe in there because sentimentally he just died and I feel like he should be 10.
That's crazy.
That shouldn't be your fucking what's it called?
I don't care.
That's grime.
Yeah. I don't care.
That's grime.
I don't give a shit. Okay. You know what? It made me take a second look, and you know what? Kobe was nice. Number 10. I mean, we always thought he was nice. I'm saying like top 10. Usually he would be like top 12.
Yeah. Okay.
But top 10, he jumped. He jumped over the, you know, Curry. Okay. Definitely. Okay. And then the extra person, number 10, you know what? Because I agree with everybody else on this list. That's tough, man. Jordan, LeBron, Kareem, Magic, Bird, Shaq, Duncan. We think Russell should be off. So then do we put Kobe, Wilt, Curry?
I'm putting for the fact that I never got to see Wilt in my lifetime play, it's hard. Is
yeah,
it?
But this man has like 30 rebound seasons and 50 points a game.
No. He's I might put him six. Right outside. Wilt? Yeah, I might put Wilt right outside the top 10.
Yeah.
Right outside the top 5. Though. Yeah, he's on
so
the list.
So that's the list.
Yeah.
Jordan, LeBron, Kareem, Magic, Bird, Shaq, Duncan, Kobe, Wilt, and Curry. Anything bleak?
I'm not taking Bill off the list.
Okay. So you're taking Curry off the list and putting Kobe?
Yes. Bill created the block.
I'm taking. If I take Curry off the list, I'm replacing him with KD.
And
KD's
not
definitely
Kobe? Going in there.
No, I'm taking Russell off.
Slide Wilt up, so it'll be Kobe and Curry at the end. Or Kobe and KD at the end.
Yeah, it's either Kobe, Curry, Kobe, KD. One of the two.
Okay. I think personally, the biggest problem I have with this list is that LeBron James is number 2. He should be number 1, clearly.
No, they got that right.
One,
the
A,
real
one
GOAT.
B.
What do you mean? What do you, it's
and
number
then,
2.
And
look
then
at
3
you.
Would be Kareem. And then everything else is decent, you know. And then I definitely take Curry out of that. How does Curry make that list? That doesn't make any sense. And I put Kobe there. So you know what? I'll leave everything else and just take Curry out and put Kobe. And then I'm good.
So what about, oh, so you keep a Bill Russell.
Yeah, man,
it's 15 points a game.
I was insane for thinking to take
it is 15 points a game.
Oh, producer.
Hakeem is not top 10.
There's wow. There's like too many centers better than him.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
David Robinson.
Hakeem is the fucking man, though. But like,
Shaq's better than him.
Shaq is better than
Wilt's
him.
Wilt's better than him. Ooh. Kareem's better than him.
There's already 3 centers out of 10. What are we going to do here? Mm. You know what I mean?
He has 2 chips, though.
I know, but
Steph Curry got 3.
Oh, my God. They love this
shit. I mean, change basketball. Steph Curry changed basketball. Changed the way they can play basketball.
Every single one of them.
And on the other half, go to Kobe. They don't consider Kobe top 10. So.
What about Iverson getting robbed of $500,000 worth of jewelry?
Yeah, in a hotel. He left it in a book bag in the lobby.
Oh, so he didn't get robbed. He was just being stupid.
Or he had it there and the guy took it.
Is there footages?
I don't think there's footages. I think there's just pictures of the kid leaving.
So there's footages. Does he have the bag in his hand? That's footages.
If it was in a hotel, it's definitely
they haven't put
footage.
Out the video. I'm just saying
Okay.
There's a shot of him walking.
Good.
$500,000. You think he gassed it? He probably had like $100,000. He's like, yeah, let me get
that's
this back. Let me get something back.
He's from that time frame where you have that time period where you had all that shit. You actually had. It's about being true to what you say you are.
Yeah, but so, at this point in time, you know, you just tell the insurance nigga, you know, oh, it's $500,000. Probably like $100,000.
I mean, they have to show proof. They got to show the proof of the receipts. Show proof.
Look at all these pictures. Look how fire my
shit. No, the actual receipts.
Fire, fire.
You think so? I think they just listen to you sometimes when you're rich.
No, they...
It's
no.
true. Do they
listen,
I believe it.
Do they listen to you when you call them up and say that...
I'm not rich. Not yet. So I'm still black. Regular black. Not rich black. It's different.
You're still a nigga.
Yeah, from far away. But up close, they know who you are. From far away, you'll get killed just like me, but up close... Oh, shit. I know who you are.
Yeah, right?
You're not like the rest of them.
You're OJ.
Your life matters. You guys want to talk about the Grammys, music?
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah.
But let's take a...
Oh, yeah, we'll talk about that.
So, Grammys, what's up? Who won some Grammys? Give me some name, Grammy winners.
Tyler, the Creator, won Best Rap Album.
Tyler, the Creator.
Oh, Tyler, Creator got a shout-out from his man, right?
Yeah. Jaden Smith said, my boyfriend won a Grammy.
So we know this is Tyler, right? Or we just...
I believe so.
Are we jumping out the window by saying Tyler?
I don't think so.
Is it slander or something?
I don't think so.
No, not at all.
If it's not you, Tyler, I apologize, but I think he's been saying that he's gay for a long time, or he has a boyfriend.
They're mad cool with each other.
Him and Jaden
They have mad pictures together, so...
But he's been saying that he has a boyfriend
for
years now. Everyone thinks it's trolling,
yeah.
But I think he really does have a boyfriend.
Wow.
Hey, yo. Dip with the hot takes.
Yeah, I don't even know, man.
If that's his boyfriend, then wow, what a power couple, huh?
Yeah, son.
Power couple. Seriously. I mean, why would you joke about something like that if it ain't true? I don't know. Because
he's going to be like, yo, he's going to be like, he's a boy and he's my friend.
Yeah, like, I've never joked. Like, hey, I have a boyfriend. Anything? Oh, my God. I've never.
No, I think they're trying to make it seem like trolling, but in actuality, they're exactly what they're doing. There. Yo, I'm telling you, I've been told you I was gay. Yeah, I didn't want to believe you. You thought it was jokes.
Yeah.
But nah.
But no.
But they're like jokesters, so you really never know.
Nah. I don't know anybody that jokes like that.
Have we seen them with women?
No.
It's a good question. I don't know anything.
Jaden Smith was the fucking Karate Kid, my nigga.
Yeah, he was the Messiah, which I thought.
I think Jackie Chan put the juju on him or something. When he put
Don't you dare throw that on Jackie Chan.
He put the wrong...
Don't Jackie you dare.
Chan is, he asked him for the...
Jackie Chan is Hollywood royalty.
Yes.
He said, I want to kick his ass, not...
American royalty at that point. That's Jackie Chan.
I want the other one, not the...
What?
He gave him the wrong joke.
Chill, B.
He gave him the wrong...
The wrong pill? The wrong pill?
Wax on?
Yeah, don't put that on him.
No, he asked for a different one. How's it? Okay.
Oh,
all right.
All right.
All right.
Nah, man.
So hold on.
So Jaden Smith, Tyler the Creator, what a power couple.
Yeah.
So Grammys.
Yeah.
Who won some Grammys, guys?
Yo, Nipsey Hussle won.
Shout out to Nipsey Hussle. Yeah. You got your Grammy, Nipsey.
Your girl won a. What did J. Cole win?
Best rap song.
With Roddy Ricch? No, not J. Cole. J. Cole won with 21 Savage, didn't he?
Yeah, it was 21 Savage.
No, but your girl Lizzo won.
How many?
Shout out to your boot thing, yo.
Shout out to Lizzo. We're proud of you. You won your Grammys. Even though the Grammys are a sham, we'll still take it where we get it. We'll still take it.
You heard Tyler saying how he feels.
And shout out to Tyler. He won Best Rap Album.
Yeah, you heard how he said that he feels that he hates being considered urban when he makes a whole bunch of different type of music.
Yeah,
all black people get thrown into either the urban or the rap or the R&B category when they make so much more than just
that. We should play what he said.
On one side, I'm very grateful that what I made could just be, you know, acknowledged in a world like this. But also, it sucks that whenever we, and I mean guys that look like me, do anything that's genre bending or that's anything, they always put it in a rap or urban category, which is, and I don't like that urban word. It's just a politically correct way to say the N-word to me. So when I hear that, I'm just like, why can't we just be in pop? Why can't it just, you know what I mean? So I felt like a half of me feels like the rap nomination was a backhanded compliment. Like, my little cousin wants to play the game. Let's give him the unplugged controller so he could shut up and feel good about it. That's what it felt like a bit. But another half of me is very grateful that the art that I made could be acknowledged on a level like this when I don't do the radio stuff. I'm not played in Target. I'm in a whole different world than what a lot of people here listen to. So I'm grateful and like, eh.
Yeah.
And I agree with basically everything he just said right there.
Yeah,
I agree with that. I always think that when people say urban or ghetto, that's just mad racist. They're just trying to say black in another way. Whenever I hear somebody's like, oh, that's so ghetto, I'd be like,
You racist bitch. You racist.
But anyway, yeah, so Lizzo won a whole lot of Grammys.
Billie Eilish won mad Grammys.
Billie Eilish is
she
super
won like
talented,
everything.
But there's something about Billie Eilish I want to ask y'all about. Okay. Tell me how you feel about this. So, Billie Eilish, green hair, super crazy nails, super bright urban clothing, right?
Uh-huh.
And they say like, wow, what a case of self-expression and exuberance and youth.
Yes.
And just
creativity.
Creativity. But it's unprofessional and hood and ratchet and ghetto.
Right.
People dress like that every day and always have colored hair and nails and all that.
But why do they what? They like this?
Why is it okay for her to do it?
Because she's white.
But it's unprofessional.
Because she's white.
That's why? She's straight because she's white. Yeah, makes sense. Like when they invented the do-rag a couple years ago.
They can get away with more stuff.
You know, white people invented the do-rag about 4 years ago.
They did.
Yeah. White people also invented corduroys.
Yeah, Kylie Jenner, right?
Yeah.
Mm. Nah, don't put that on.
No, what's her name? From the beach.
Yeah?
Oh,
Bo Derek. Yeah.
Bo Derek, first woman with braids.
1978 corduroys. Or something like that.
1978. Yeah. White people invent a lot of good stuff, huh?
Yeah.
I think they also did hot sauce. I think they got hot sauce too.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yo, man, Hillary Clinton, Hillary stays with the hot sauce in the purse. Yeah, that's not pandering.
Trust.
She stays with a hot sauce in the purse and takes her man to Red Lobster. I don't think Hillary Clinton has ever ate a Red Lobster in her life. Mm-hmm.
But whatever. So Billie Eilish.
Yeah, crazy.
Still shout out to you because you're very talented. We're not gonna hate on you.
That has nothing to do with the music.
So more music.
Coffee got one too.
Coffee.
Oh, yeah.
Jamaica,
yeah.
We in the house, Jamaica.
Yeah, we in the house, we did
it.
Baby.
We do it every year. We always, they gave us a whole reggae. Mm-hmm. They gave us our own.
One of us kill it every year.
Yeah, we did it. It's usually a Marley, but we'll take it.
Facts.
So music, let's stay on music. Mm-hmm. Nicki Minaj's brother, jail, 25 to life.
Aguanta.
They're going to treat them real good in jail. Yeah. They love it when you
raping
touch kids.
Little girls. Yeah, see what happens when you rape little girls?
They'll make sure you you pay that on the other side.
Yeah, they do. They do, man. That shit is...
And let's stick on Nicki Minaj. Nicki Minaj and Meek Mill ran into each other at a store in California.
Yeah, Grammy weekend.
And it wasn't the best exchange.
Yeah, it was a little heated, a little screaming match.
What do you guys think about...
So, no. Set it up.
What do you guys think about running into an ex when you're with your girl? How do you handle that situation? Have you done this before? Is it something you've gone through? Run into an ex or somebody who's like been interested or chasing after you type shit, and you run into them while you're with your girlfriend. Yeah. Do you acknowledge them? How do you handle the situation?
Fortunately, I've honestly never been in that situation. So.
But if you were in that situation,
maybe I have some firsthand experience, and then maybe I'll tell you how I
work. Me? Let me go into that bank, that memory bank, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've been in that situation.
And how did you handle that?
Man, ice cold feet. Shit is crazy. You get that rush, like your heart, you know.
Yeah.
You got to make a quick decision.
Mm-hmm. What decision did you make? And is that a decision that you would make again in the future, or do you have a whole new strategy now that you've been through it?
No, I ignored.
You ignored the person. They did not exist. Did they? Were they like, okay, I'm going to be. Hey, hello, how are you doing, Bleak?
Did your current girl know who that was without even having to for you to say something, or she without you saying anything, she had no idea who she was.
No, she had no idea who she was.
Uh-huh.
Then I said,
so it was safe.
No, it wasn't safe.
Because you didn't know what the ex would have did.
The ex saw me and kind of like, you know, then you get that.
That would, like, well, you know her?
Yeah.
Why are you guys, what's going on here? Something going on here?
Yeah, man, you know, shit never ends good. So
No, that's not true.
You're gonna get that look, and girls pick that up good. In a second. They pick that up.
I have good exes. My exes, for the most part, 90%, we're good.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I mean, you don't close doors. You say you don't.
I said. Close books, you don't. When you say I don't close doors, it sounds devious. It sounds like some chicanery.
Oh, I'm sorry.
But it's not chicanery.
Let's rewind. All right?
No, that's all good. It's all good. But yeah, I have good relationships. It was amicable. Okay. All the separations were amicable.
I got you. It was a mutual agreement.
Mutual agreement, definitely. But I have had the situation happen to me, and
do tell.
A few situations.
What are the deets?
Please.
Here we go. I'm ready to spill. So
lock in.
Whoa.
Let's do it. One time I was, 2 o'clock in the morning. I'm at. Nothing I don't like want to shout them out, but 2 o'clock in the morning, I'm at the supermarket. What supermarket's open at 2 o'clock? You know what I mean?
The 24-hour spot.
Yeah.
Oh. 7-Eleven.
So, I mean, we're going to bleep that out.
Oh.
Yeah, we're not saying names. Of places.
Oh, yeah. So say it again.
So 2 o'clock in the morning, I'm at one of those 2 o'clock
in the
morning.
You're at the 24-hour convenience spots.
Yeah, One of those big, I'm walking around with the cart, and I'm with my significant other, and I see one of my exes.
Dun, dun, dun.
And this is not like a regular ex. This is one of those exes like... like five years. Because I'm a serial monogamous.
Black men don't cheat.
I don't cheat. I like to stay in a committed relationship. That just makes me feel more comfortable when I'm secure in my love and my relationship.
Because you can give your all then.
And that's what you're supposed to do. When you're in a relationship, you give your all. Because what else would you be doing?
Consent boys. Him.
Nobody's trying to have... Yeah, well...
Consent boys.
Yeah, consent boys.
Consent boys in the building.
Consent boys in the building, yeah.
Consent boys in the building. So I ran into an ex, and this was one of those exes where even though it was an amicable split, I feel like there was lingering emotions on her side.
Oof. So don't you hate those?
I seen her in the supermarket, and I was like, you know what, baby girl? Maybe we need some paper towels.
Ooh, aguantate.
And I tried to avert.
Let's see.
Avoid. You know what I mean? And go left into another aisle.
Yeah.
Made eye contact with the ex, and then she looked at me. I made the turn with my girl, and she was like, okay.
Oh, you're not going to talk to me?
So you're
going to
disrespect me like I don't exist.
Exactly.
Walked up to me and was like, hey, Aim, what's up?
What's going on?
So
nice to see you here at 2 in the morning.
So my significant other is
you on your usual juice run?
Let me see how this is going to play out for 30 seconds.
No, G. Talk to her.
She's like,
this is a friend.
Let's see. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna have to go scorched earth here, because at this point in time, anything else looks bad.
It's gonna look like something bad's gonna happen. You still haven't answered the first question.
So I'd be like, you're bugging out. I haven't talked to you in a while long. You're being mad disrespectful.
You're a crazy.
Obviously, I'm with my girl. You're wilding out.
You're disrespectful. You walk by me, you act like you don't know me.
And that's exactly what happened.
Yeah, you out here acting like you wasn't trying to holler at me last night.
That didn't happen.
Oh, so that didn't happen.
Oh,
it was more of a don't disrespect me like you don't know me. You can't talk to me.
Yeah.
I've known you forever. You can't talk to me.
Oh, got you.
So, yeah, a little disrespect. She was mad at me for a while for dressing her down like that. But
of course.
She has to understand I was with my girl and things had to be done, you know? That's how I handled that situation, personally.
Yeah. But you didn't get that cold feet? You didn't get that rush?
Oh, yeah, I was shook.
Come on, man. That's
because no matter what, I was more shook at how bad it looks, because it looks bad.
All right, let me ask y'all a question.
Yeah, because then you can lose both.
What gets you more shook? What's more shook? That happening? Or when you see the cops pull behind you and you don't know if they're trying to pull you over or not, but what races your heart more?
Wow, I think
the cops is life or death more of the time than it is life or death. Your girl is life or death too sometimes.
You dig?
Some shit is life or death. If your girl ever came home and you just had a girl in the crib, no matter what, that shit is life or death. You're dead.
Yeah.
The girl could be literally on the floor in the living room bleeding out, like one of her legs is severed. And your girl be like, oh, so you fucking bitches with one leg in here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you went to that dirty shit, that bloody shit.
That snuff shit. You're trying to do it. You're doing snuff porn and in the crib. What the fuck is wrong with you?
Disgusting.
Necrophilia.
Did you
joke.
Have a girl in your crib? And your girl come home? Is no. there any way out of that?
No, there's no way out of that. How would you want a way out of that? You can't want a way out of that. That's it.
What if something really like crazy happened? Like you're outside walking with a friend.
So then you just gotta trust that she believes whatever the hell you come up with. Whatever it is you come up with, if she believes it, then you know, it is what it is.
Okay.
But bro, there's no getting way out of that.
There's no way out of that.
Yeah, you just say whatever came up right there.
Anybody seen any new movies? Bad Boys 3, guys seen that yet?
No, not yet, man.
I heard Bad Boys 3 is fire.
It's amazing.
I'm sure, but I haven't watched it yet.
No, but I've heard nothing but good things from people I do respect and some good things from people who are dumbasses, but, you know, sometimes there's layers to shit. And
they are
the dumbasses get a good, you know, even a garbage can gets a steak.
A dick?
Even a garbage can gets a steak.
No, movies. Kirby Enthusiasm's back.
Oh, my man Larry David. That's one of the best comedy sitcoms I've ever seen in my life. Yeah. It's hilarious. Yeah. I always recommend that. Kirby Enthusiasm. That's one of my favorite comedies. We can get into some great comedies. Yeah. You want to do that real quick?
Is it better than Martin?
Can I ask something?
Go ahead. You can ask anything, man.
Is it better than
Martin? That's just a good comedy, period, right?
It's facts.
It's just a good comedy, right?
Facts.
I come across a good amount of, well, not a good amount. I come across a handful of people, a handful of my friends who are not, they like Curb Your Enthusiasm, but they're not always open for the comedy or the thing, the movie or the show, if it doesn't have an ample amount of necessarily down. Yeah.
If it doesn't have a wild black people, they're not.
If it doesn't have black people on
Friends.
It. I mean, why are we going to Friends?
They're not
going to
watch Seinfeld.
They're not going to watch.
They're not going to watch Frasier.
I know people that won't watch Breaking Bad because it's not black.
They're not
going to
watch
it.
Cheers.
I mean, you're picking like '90s shows that are like overly white. I'm not talking about those. Seinfeld's, yes.
Big Bang Theory.
I mean, Ozark. Not them. I'm
How
not
I
talking
Met
about
Your Mother.
Ozark.
I'm not talking about none of those shows.
Okay.
I'm talking about
New
just.
Girl.
The Office. The Office. There you go. The Office.
That's one of my favorite shows. That's probably, I think, the best comedy, best sitcom I've ever seen.
That or Seinfeld for me.
And then, Martin sitcom. Is up there. Martin's up there.
Good.
But it's,
stop disrespecting.
And it's, but the Office the is better than Martin. I don't care. My bad card is legit anywhere
yo,
I go.
It's
I don't
so,
care
it's, real quick, we can touch on Martin real quick. It's so grime that it seems like there was never any beef between Martin and Gina, and there was just rumors, and I feel that's why the show fucking wrapped as soon as it did, because the last season, the last half of the season, she wasn't filming with him. So, like, I just feel that's unfortunate that we could have got a couple more years of good Martin TV.
Yeah.
But people's egos and stuff like
I
that.
I heard a completely different situation.
No,
it sounds like Tisha Campbell doesn't want to say something that she has to say.
She signed an NDA.
About some sexual assault and all kinds of shit. That some murky shit that she don't really want to talk about.
But he said never happened.
It happened.
He said it never happened. And
she signed the NDA.
Okay, so that's it.
She signed an NDA. I know she did.
So, you know what I mean? It's one of those things.
It's over. It's done.
But...
It didn't happen.
She said she was just listening to too many people. She did say that. She was like, yo, I can't say much, but she was like, I was listening to the wrong people.
Exactly. And that happens. And that's not on her, man. So you know.
I mean, ego.
Anything more about comedies, sitcoms? You want to keep talking about that or are we out of there?
Shows?
There's just bad
funny shows, man. I like
we can
funny
just, we can. That was all good. We can cut that up and have the Martin shit and then that.
Yeah.
All right, so you want to get out of that?
I think another funny show is Shameless. I like this season.
Shameless is pretty good, too.
Yeah, I don't really have any interest in watching crazy white people.
You see what I mean?
I'll
just watch the news.
Watch the news. That's a good point, too.
If you like
I tried to watch that show. I thought that shit was filth. It was just filth.
It was filth. Yeah?
The show was, like, disgusting.
Dip thinks the same. I mean...
I mean, the first.
I liked it.
Really good.
Shit.
Hey,
I like filth.
Everybody likes what they like.
Right? I like filth.
Just,
oh, okay, great.
That's a straight thumbs down for me. Shameless. Thumbs down.
Jeez. How about Ozark? It's coming soon.
Ozark, thumbs down.
Yeah,
moving on.
Moving on?
Ozark, trash.
Damn.
Moving on.
Ozark is not trash.
So what's fire to you?
Yeah, wow.
You know a lot of shit's fire to me. Come on, don't do that.
Don't do that.
Give me some. We're naming stuff in your.
And you're just shutting
it down. What are we talking about? A series or
you shutting shit down like you Oprah, bro?
Yeah, like
relax.
Like you
Oprah shut down her investigation of Russell Simmons.
yeah, like she shut, you know.
Why she shut that down?
Yeah, I don't even know.
Oprah was out here slaying all the black people. What happened?
She slaying all the black men, not black people.
Black men.
Black men. Just black men.
She's got like a vendetta.
Why wasn't she slaying Harvey Weinstein?
Because that's her friend.
Look at that. Michael wasn't her friend, right?
She's cool. No.
I guess Michael wasn't her friend.
Damn, man. The white boy said they lied.
Mm-hmm. The dick? Grub, man.
Yo, all I know is the FBI was investigating Mike for years, and they couldn't find nothing.
Never did they.
I heard that Lori Harvey and Future are engaged.
Yeah.
Shout out to Future, bro. You the man. Yeah. Shout out to him, bro. Taking that.
Or there's rumors that they're engaged.
Rumors.
Lori Harvey has been spotted wearing a sizable ring.
You could take it
on the finger that you would wear the ring on. And she's been spending a lot of time with the wizard himself recently.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's gonna take her to Pluto.
Future has 9 baby moms.
Yeah, he's taking her to Pluto.
Listen, man, what is the point of life to multiply and be fruitful?
I didn't know that's where you were going.
It is.
It's in the Bible. That's a fact.
You're gonna go with that?
Have more children.
You didn't give that half answer? You didn't let that half answer rock? Not gonna give people the full? You didn't deny?
Yo, so you heard about these two stories. They happened over the last few months, but I just think it's weird. And I want to know what you guys would do in a situation similar. Can we go on another blunt? That's not possible.
I think so.
So one guy had found a sizable amount. I don't remember the exact amount, so I don't want to butcher it.
Yeah.
Of money in a couch that he bought from like the Salvation Army.
Oh, yes.
And he returned it.
Yeah.
And then somebody found, what, $27,000? What did they find that at?
Yeah.
I don't know.
They found $27,000 by like a Western Union or some shit like that.
Yeah.
And brought it back and like, hey, somebody left their money.
Wow.
What do you think about those people who've done that? Do you think that's like an honorable, noble thing to do?
It's a real honorable thing.
Amazing.
And what would you do in that similar situation?
Yeah, it's very honorable to do. Very, very honorable to do.
Do you think it's the right thing to do?
I think it's a great man would do that.
I'm keeping it.
Do you think it's the right thing to do, Bleak?
I'm keeping it.
I think I hear you saying something, but I can't quite make it.
I'm keeping it.
Why are you're gonna keep it, Bleak?
I'm keeping every single dime.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Now, I decide to.
What if you see somebody drop it?
No, I'm giving it back if they drop it.
Okay. What if it's like?
If I see the person,
I'm sorry, Chrome. But if I cut a hole in my couch
and find money, 20 racks in there,
obviously that was for me.
You keep that. You keep that couch money. But if you see somebody who was at like a Western Union or something like that, I mean, you try and get that back to that person because who knows what that person needs that money for to send it to somebody.
Have you ever gotten something valuable or something that you lost or left like returned to you?
Yeah.
Yes.
So you're paying that forward basically.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good thing to do.
Not but, the couch but that money, couch though. Money's mine.
Yeah, that's for me. That I'm here. 47? Wow.
It was 27. But yeah, it could be
yeah,
anywhere.
We go to DR. Yeah. Crazy. Semana Santa. We out to DR. Está loco.
Okay, have you guys heard about this coronavirus?
Oh.
I don't drink Coronas.
You dig?
We drink Modelo, so we good over here, baby.
You dig?
Or we drink other beers.
We drink.
Other than Corona.
Yeah, we drink a lot of it. We don't drink. I don't. I mean, I personally, and if you know me, you know I don't drink Coronas. So that's. I gave that up a long time ago. I graduated. You know?
Okay, so I have some viewer questions, and I also have. People wanted to know more about us. They said even though they're getting to know our personalities, they want some actual concrete answers from us. So they wanted to know what are our favorite munchies, each of us? You smoke, you get high, you need the munchies, you're not eating a real meal. What's your go-to munchie?
Linden
chocolate.
Cookies. The chocolate.
Which one?
The,
I'm going with Oreos.
Nah, the Linden ones, you know the grandmama cookies, the ones that got
which
with
one? The yellow pack?
The yellow pack.
That's the butter crunch. That's
butter
my favorite.
Crunch. Yeah, that's first.
That's delicious. That's delicious.
M&M's.
Yuck. M&M's, which M&M's?
Peanuts.
Yellow M&M's? Fire.
Yes.
Yellow then, bag, heat rockery so far. I agree with you.
Yeah, facts.
That's it?
Those are like the most that I go to.
Oh, you I'm a simple man. There's so many things I can go with, but I'm just, for the sake of time, I'm just going to do a couple joints. I like the 50 Cent Nacho Twister bag.
Okay.
Those are delicious. 50 Cent, it's a great bag for your buck. If they have those, you try to get those.
Okay.
I also, like, I'm a weird dude, so, like, sometimes I try to be a little healthy. I get the sunflower seeds, like, just the kernels. I don't even need the shell with all the salt on it. Just give me the kernels. Make sure they roast it. I'm good with that. Some peanuts, maybe some trail mix. If I'm feeling crazy, I'll do the chocolate with the M&Ms in it or something like that. Or like a nice chocolate mix.
Yeah.
But I try to keep it fake healthy. And then I might get a coconut water or coconut juice. You know, my munchies are still kind of, you
the
know.
Coconut water always hits.
Yeah. Or the coconut juice if I'm having a cheat day. I'll get the coconut juice. You know who you are. Throw me the bread. You know I drink you all the time. I'll be in the stores. You see me?
If we're going through the gamut, I like everything. Like, I mean, I like.
Come on. I like. Give us. They want to know about us.
Yeah, I'm telling you what I actually like to have and what I do have. Like seaweed, like the seaweed chips, like the long, see the spicy joints, those. I like apples with peanut butter on it.
Okay, regular
like,
in the crib.
I like the Oreos. I like chocolate chip cookie dough ice cream.
Chocolate chip
like,
cookie dough, the ice cream?
Y'all yeah, here talking about healthy shit.
No, no, no. I like
chocolate chip cookie dough ice cream. That's not healthy.
I like,
you come back.
So you got, that's it? Munchies? And you got more? Because I got more too, man.
Yeah, I got a lot more now that we're going into some
anything
healthy
else?
Shit.
Or before we
I like cakes and
peanut butter, bro. That peanut butter, man.
Anything on anything.
Oh, my God. The peanut butter munchies you heard on the wheat bread.
So we did the munchies. We did a little taste of the munchies. I know we wanted to get into it more, but what is your favorite meal now? They're asking. Your favorite meal.
That's so hard.
No, what's the... Hey... Make this for me. Or, hey, we're going to go to the best person that makes all right, this.
All right. I want fried white and grits and baked beans.
Okay. And that's probably going to be Mom Duke's. Because that sounds like a sounds like a personal. Yeah. That's not on Mad Menus. That's something that you.
That's what I'm saying.
That Mom Duke's
that's
makes.
Southern. That's that Southern.
You heard me? What about you?
My girl makes it good,
if
too.
If we're going personal, it's definitely going to be white rice, black beans. Steak. That's always OD.
What kind of steak though? Like what cut? You like the skirt steak or are you talking about like a T-bone or a
so about that Dominican steak.
Like not, a steak steak.
That thin steak.
You want that skirt steak.
That skirt
steak.
That skirt steak. Like, churrasco.
Not like churrasco because I'm talking personal. So
yeah, it's what you want. Oh,
that's
so
what
homemade.
I'm talking about. Personal,
okay.
Homemade.
Okay.
So it's like bistec en salsa. So it's like, you know, like beef stew.
Okay.
Fire. I love beef stew. That's literally the only thing I get at any Dominican restaurant
exactly,
is the beef
when
stew.
It's homemade, you know.
It's so, even more perfect.
I love Jamaican food, Jamaican food, Jamaican food.
Yeah.
So you cook Jamaican food, I'm there for you. Like, you that's 35% of the game. You almost bagged me. But my favorite meal, and it's a rare meal, not too many people make it. I love stew peas and white rice, but I want the stew peas made with salt beef because I don't eat pork. You feel me? And not a lot of people. Not a lot
Mom
of people
Dukes makes that.
Mom Dukes makes that.
There you
Grandma
go.
Grandma made that. You feel me? And that's the fires. You feel me? To me.
Right.
That's like a. If somebody makes that for me, like wow, that's a lot of like wow. You good looks.
You love
not
me.
A lot of people make that. Yeah. It's hard to make that. Because you got to find the salt beef.
Right.
It's like cured beef.
Right, right,
you have
right.
To actually
right.
find that. Like, that's not
yeah, that's not just laying around
yeah,
the average
exactly.
Yeah. Supermarket cardo.
Yeah, and it's dangerous as fuck. I mean, that's so much sodium. That's probably just a heart attack in a plate, but it's so fucking delicious.
Mm-hmm.
With the dumplings, the spinners.
Man, I like bad food.
Yeah, man.
So, all right, so that's the favorite food, right? We all did that. Favorite team? Hey. You can go through all the major sports. We do all three right. sports. We'll do basketball, baseball, and football, right?
All right, so basketball team. I don't have a favorite basketball team. I have a favorite football team.
Do you have any basketball allegiance?
I just like, for certain blocks and years, I be messing with one player.
Okay, so you're a whore in basketball. Next.
I mean,
you are a whore. You just go from whoever you want to go to.
He's
an
NBA fan.
No. I'm an NBA fan.
NBA fan.
Nah, I don't. There's not one team I really mess with in basketball.
NBA fan. Yeah. So you're
Football is Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Baseball is the Yankees.
Okay. Bleak?
Tampa Bay what?
Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
It's football. It doesn't matter.
All right. Football, even though I hate to say it, but the Giants.
Okay.
Baseball, Yankees all day since forever. And basketball, the Lakers.
Why is that?
LeBron.
Okay, so.
Why would I?
So you used to be a Cavs fan?
Huh?
Did you used to be a Cavs fan when when LeBron was on the Lakers?
I was a Cavs fan.
And then
I went to Cleveland and all that.
And then were you a Heat fan when he was on the Heat?
No, no, Melo was in New York, so.
Oh, then you were. So is he a basketball hoe too?
I think so.
I wouldn't say a whore.
Look,
you know, he has a past.
So
he has a sordid past.
Listen, let me tell you
worse than mine.
At the beginning of all of this,
that's worse than mine. It sounds like he's riding. It sounds like he's riding with the player too.
Everybody has a player, but at least they're staying with one player.
Really.
You're jumping around from player to player.
No, I'm not. But you know me. No,
whoever's the hottest.
You know I'm a Melo fan. Melo's been in the league the last 17 years, so I've been a Melo fan.
Then you were rode Steph Curry for years.
No, I didn't ride Steph Curry. I thought they were good teams. I thought they were a good team.
So
you didn't think. They were a good team.
I'm only watching winning basketball.
Oh.
LA is winning basketball.
Is it?
Yes.
And then for me.
When was the last time they won?
It's okay. It's all right.
No, when was the last time LA won?
2009. What was it, like Friday?
Oh, 2009.
Last week, Friday.
Oh, last decade. Last decade.
They won in games. They just won a few games a few days ago.
So he's talking about whole shit.
Right now.
He's talking about regular season whole shit.
Oh, regular season.
No, I'm just talking
shit.
About in the
season. He said he's watching winning basketball. Oh, you only worry about the regular
winning
season.
Basketball.
So why not be a Rockets fan? Then?
No, they're not winning.
They win bad regular season games.
LA, all right,
so let's stick to
basketball.
This so we can get the fuck out of here.
Okay.
My teams are the Yankees for baseball,
yes,
without
of course.
A doubt.
We all know that.
Of course.
For football, the Giants, without a doubt.
Yes.
And I have a dual allegiance in basketball. I don't care what the fuck you have
We're
to say about
to
it.
We're not going to accept dual
I'm
allegiance.
I'm a Knicks fan over everything. But I also am a supporter of the LeBron James movement.
Oh, so
and
you're a
so now we are Lakers supporters.
Who says
you're
things
a,
like
so
this to
home.
Describe what they
I've been
like.
A Melo fan, so I mean, I guess I've been a Knicks and a Nuggets.
Yeah, we've had some cross. There's been some cross section at some
so
time.
That,
we were both
that mean,
Knicks
oh,
fans.
If that's the case, then I've had three teams that I've liked over the past 17 years. All right,
so the teams is a mystery and a fog. We did the food munchies. Favorite sneaker? That's gonna be too much of a bullshit again.
Yeah. No, it's we'll not. What do you mean? How's it bullshit?
I don't want to talk about.
How's
it?
No, is it? Is
Let's
your
get
own?
Into these viewer
no, it's a, huh? is your yes. favorite sneaker? How's it?
What's your favorite sneaker?
The fours.
Okay.
The fours. Just
yeah.
the fours.
Yeah, 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 the fours are my favorite sneaker.
Oh, man.
Bleak.
The bread fours. If I have to be specific.
The 12s. Which 12s?
Yes. Huh?
Which 12s?
Any. All of them.
Okay.
No, seriously. The
yeah, yeah,
the
that's what you're asking.
The
favorite sneaker.
All of them, all
your favorite sneaker.
Yeah, yeah, all of them.
And then you can say favorite colorway.
I'm not going to lie, the fours are also my favorite sneaker. I know you love to go first, so sometimes you take
some
of the things
you
I'm going to say.
See, you guys.
But, that blows my
hey,
shit.
Hey, Kim.
but I love the fours.
Yeah, fours are fire.
Bread
no
fours. Yeah. Cool gray fours.
Yeah.
So
Toro fours.
Toro fours. Yeah, they go.
I would just mention another thing.
Carhartt fours.
Yeah,
okay, New Balance boys.
Mellow fours.
So, some viewer situations. let's get it in.
Nah, that's what
if
happened.
You have to choose one of these, which one will you choose?
I choose to go right. Oh, yeah, because I ain't getting left. You heard
me? All right. So, you have to choose between one of these two scenarios. Mm-hmm. Amazing relationship. Horrible sex.
Oh, shit.
Amazing, incredible sex. Horrible, toxic relationship.
Now, great relationship, horrible sex. Sex can be worked on. It's like a muscle.
It's horrible, though. Like, she doesn't even arch her back.
It's a muscle. It could be worked on. If it's toxic, get
it's
it
an
out
activity.
Of here.
Yeah. That could be worked on.
Chrome?
In a perfect world, my girl would be somewhere in the middle. So,
and now for the scenario?
I mean, if I have to choose one?
Yes, that's the scenario. That's the decision. It's between one of the two.
I'm gonna, like Bleak said, I'm going to agree with Bleak. I would have to take the great relationship because sex is only a certain amount of minutes in a 24-hour day. And exactly. If I can't really sit down and just spend the day just hanging out with you, like, it's going to be over quick.
Yeah.
Have you guys ever
And sex doesn't apply to top.
Yes, that's part of sex. Yes, it is. That's actually sex.
You're trying to be slick here, Gary.
That's called sex. Oral sex.
It's like a subject.
It's mathematics. It's like science. Can't argue with science.
There's some girls that say that if you do it in the butt, you're still a virgin.
Hey, but that's also sex.
No. It's anal.
Butt sex.
No, it's just anal.
Category.
It's just anal. No, anal.
All right, but anyway,
that's all I'm saying.
So, have you guys ever had amazing sex?
Yes, all the time.
All the time. That happens all the time.
Yeah.
So how do you know it's amazing?
If it happens all the time. Because it's amazing every time. It feels just as good every single time.
Okay, so then we're moving on then. So you guys chose what you chose, and we're moving on.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Good luck to me. All right, cool.
So, so another viewer question. How do you tell a female that you're not sexually attracted to her?
That's almost impossible.
You make him an excuse to not be in that situation, and you just never hit her again.
So you ghost her.
Yeah.
That's the best way.
Yeah.
Bleak.
What? She just don't tell her. That's not.
I think that's almost impossible.
Like.
To tell a girl.
Like if you don't find her attractive, then you can hit her with any excuse. Yo, I have to take that meat. I'm doing it in your crib, so I'll be. Let's do this again another time, and just never hit her back.
So tell her that you have to take a shit, so you have to leave, and then never talk to her again. Yeah. That's the best way to do it.
I mean, you don't have to tell her. You're not actually telling her that you don't find her attractive. You're just never putting yourself in that position to ever have to tell her again.
But here at the Blunt Exchange, we try to keep it blunt and tell them the truth.
We're keeping it blunt with each other.
Okay.
Okay. All right.
That's fair.
That's true.
That's fair. That's fair. It does apply to us.
Yeah.
It makes sense.
Yeah. We don't have to keep it blunt with the people.
Blunt Exchange. I respect that. So Crump says ghoster. Bleak says...
What did I say?
I'm asking.
He's asking you now.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
How do you tell a woman you're not sexually attracted to her?
I've been here before. That was very difficult. It's ugly, bro, because they feel like shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you care that they feel like shit?
Yes.
Is that your responsibility?
But I never do. I always try to, make it better.
How do you make it better?
I never give up.
You never give up. You just stay talking to them until...
I stay in there. I keep digging.
So you just lead them on.
I keep digging.
You just lead them on.
I just keep digging.
Do you have sex with it then?
I keep working, baby.
You keep working until they give up.
Yeah. Someone's giving up.
So you're smashing through the pain.
Let's get it done.
Smashing through the pain, you do that to yourself?
It's not pain, really. You know?
That is a struggle.
You become
you're not sexually attracted to her.
You become a teacher.
She has a lopsided boy.
Yeah. Oh, shit. No, I'm out of there. That's crazy.
No, what I'm saying, she's not attractive. I'm saying, whatever it is that makes you not sexually attracted to her. She has the droopy butt.
She has three nipples.
You got to go out like a champion.
Yeah.
You gotta walk out of there.
She has like a six figure.
So you're still taking it down. Hardcore. Bleak, you're a fucking savage and it's disgusting.
Listen. Opportunities don't come around all the time, you know?
The wavy seal in the fucking building.
You gotta take advantage.
You take every opportunity. I don't even find you attractive, but
you're not gonna play me.
Yeah. You ain't gonna walk in my life and not let me smash.
Sometimes, you know?
Hold on. What are you doing? Why are you trying to jump out there? Why you be trying to not answer the questions?
If I was not sexually attracted to a woman, I would say to her, I don't know what it is, to be honest with you. I love the vibe that we're having, but so for some reason, I cannot perform.
What do you mean?
Maybe it's mental.
What do you mean, G?
Maybe it's a mental thing, but this has never happened.
But look, I'm naked.
I know I'm trying,
and I'm yours.
And it's not happening.
I want to give it to you.
Maybe it's a mental thing, and maybe we just
need
to.
You told me.
It, No, my mental's good. I want to do it.
Yeah, but my mental is not working.
For hours.
What's wrong with me?
For hours.
What's wrong with me?
What's wrong with you?
I don't know.
Is it me?
I must have a problem.
Is it me?
It's not you. It's me.
But let me help you.
There's nothing you can do.
You sure?
My friend's here.
There's nothing we can do.
I'm going to call my friends over.
Hey.
Well, then maybe there is something we can do.
Scumbag.
Okay, how would you break up with a woman?
Oh, shit.
These are the viewer questions. They want these.
What do you mean they want these? I'm not helping nobody out of shit. Nah, I'm joking.
How do you break up with a girlfriend?
And
they've been you've been together for at least a substantial time. 8 months to a year, at least. Substantial girlfriend. You've done things together. There's been a holiday.
I'm hoping there's some major event that I could just piggyback off of. Yeah. Like, you see what happened?
Independence Day, bitch. I need my independence.
No. Like, you messed up. She messed up somewhere. Right? Like, yeah. See, we was vibing until this event where you did X, Y, and Z. And unfortunately, I can't move past that anymore. Yeah. Yeah. So I know that we had a great thing in the beginning.
So you're just going to lie to her.
What do you mean? We break it up with her.
That's a white lie.
That's breaking up with her.
It's not like a lie. It's not about the
white
event. It's something else. Just tell her the truth.
Oh.
It's a white lie. Look how good white people are. They made it. Look. If you say a white lie, you're good. You're still good. It's crazy.
It's all about
it. Yeah, it's great, man. Anyway.
That's another episode.
How you doing it? How you breaking up?
Well, yeah. That's
how am I breaking up? I'm just saying, like, listen, man, this is not working for me. So
there you go. Keep it blunt.
What if she's like, I need to know more?
I like you.
I'm no longer interested in where this is going. And
but
it's not beneficial for me.
But I
so
thought
I'm
it
gonna,
was working out.
Yeah, I thought it was working out. I thought it was working out. No. We just went to.
We cannot.
We just got falafel last week.
For it to work out, it needs to be two people, and I'm not one of
no,
those
but
people.
What's wrong?
Well, tell me.
What went wrong?
No. Us is wrong.
How are us wrong?
Right. We don't match.
Did you call me over last night?
We're not a good mix. I did not call you over last night. So
why are you lying to me?
You said if I play Fabio. All
right, so we out of there.
You love me forever.
Yo.
Anything else, guys? Because
what?
We already had. This is the longest episode ever.
What?
Man.
So that's it.
Yeah, I think it was cool.
Think it's cool. Did we touch everything? Did we fuck up on anything? Stats,
wait, did I tell
stat,
you?
Stat boy. Did we?
Nigga said stat boy.
I don't know. Google guy. That's Google. Yeah, info, right. Mr. Info. All
right. So shout out to everybody in the building. Shout out to Dip. Shout out to Google guy.
Shout out to the gallery.
Shout out to
Recording
Studio.
Recording
Studio, of course. You know, I don't think we ever introduced ourselves this episode, but this episode 12, so
true.
You can go back and pick it out.
Episode 12.
To my left, I have
Krupp.
And to my right, I have
Pablo, aka Bleak.
I'm Aim Gunner. Thank you for watching The Blunt Exchange. Hit us up at Blunt Exchange at Instagram, Blunt Exchange, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. Of course, you already
know. Apple Podcasts, Spotify, you already know what it is.
Leave us a message.
Podbean.
And leave us a comment. We do
leave comments.
We do respond. And
yes, we
do. We'll see you next week. We'll try to do better next week, like we always say. Thank you for pulling up, rolling up, lighting up, and getting blunt with us.
You already know. Cheer.
Thank you for watching Blunt Exchange. Don't forget to like, subscribe to the channel, and tune in for more dope episodes. And don't forget to keep it blunt and light it.